Now, pressure is mounting on Durban police to arrest those behind the murder of social media personality Mluleki Mbewana. The 32-year-old was gunned down outside a nightclub last week. It's believed there were witnesses at the scene, and yet no arrests have been made to date. My colleague Desanthathia was at the funeral this morning, monitoring developments there. Let's start with how he was remembered, Desan.
We have a bit of a bad line, but yes, we are still at the funeral of Mluleki Mbewana, and that's in Twalume. There's been a massive turnout here, as you would be able to see from behind me as well. Some of the family members gathered in this tent that you're looking at now. There are lots of friends, colleagues, as other associates that have also come out despite this poor weather. And you'll recall that last week and ever since Mluleki's murder, there's been an outpouring of support. There's been many people that have been calling for justice for Mlu, and that is largely because they claim that he was murdered in full view of so many other people, and that they are witnesses, and they wanted to know why police had not made any arrests. But I have with me Viwe Mbewana, that's Mluleki's uncle. Mr. Mbewana, firstly, our condolences, and thank you for taking the time to chat to us. I'm sure that the family is touched by the support that Mlu has received over the past week.
Yes, it's very touched. The friends have done a lot of things that you see, beautiful things that are here in the tent, and everything has been the contribution of these guys, the friends, and all the people that are working with him. They've been coming, pouring in the family, coming, giving support, words, and money to
it seems like he was a very popular young man, and you can just see by the kind of support that he's received also on social media. What was it about Mlu that endeared him to so many people?
Mlu was very giving. He was very giving. The first thing that he did when he started work, the first project that he started, he built a house at home at Lusigisigi. We were originally coming from Lusigisigi. He went there, he built a very huge house there, and then came back to build the house for her mom at home. And then he has been supporting every time to all the siblings. They all depending on him, because he's the sole breadwinner at home.
And that's what I'm picking up here at the funeral as well, that many people are talking about his humble nature despite his success, both in his job and as well as his social life.
Yeah, he was very humble. When he's talking to you, you will think he's just a small boy with nothing. But you realize by the possessions, yes, he would not brag in the family. He would be treated like anybody, but he's got a lot of things that he possesses.
Now, I understand that the family is also concerned about the case that is being investigated, about that murder case. Have you been in contact with the police, with detectives that are investigating, and what are they saying to you?
Nothing. We decided that let's bury this guy, and then we follow up later. Otherwise, the story is still the same, that he was murdered, rich Durban, stuff like that, the one that you hear on social media. But we will not, there is nothing that is really clear as to what exactly happened. We are calling, the family has told me that we have to talk to, we are calling upon the friends, because I'm sure there were friends who were there who would know what actually happened, to come closer. Because now the kids are still very young, so very young kids who needs to be looked after. But now we're not clear what exactly happened. No one tells us.
So the family wants those witnesses to come forward. Thank you very much for your time, Mr. Mbewana. That's a plea from the family for people to come forward, particularly friends that were there on the day, to help expedite this investigation. But what I can tell you is that we've also spoken to the provincial police spokesperson, Brigadier Jane Naika, before the funeral, just to inquire about that investigation. And he's assured me that a team of detectives is working on the case. They are trying to track the suspect in this matter, and hopefully there will be an arrest soon, and ultimately that his supporters will get what they've been calling for, and that is justice for Mlu.
Thank you very much, Desan Thathia, coming to us from a very rainy Durban in KwaZulu-Natal.